Well, let's take a look at what happened on the peak of the Tau Herculid meteor shower. The Tau Herculid has turned into quite an event on this channel with many new subscribers, so thank you to all our watchers and subscribers. And I'd especially like to thank everyone for their efforts and feedback on what they saw. As it was cloudy and rainy for me, I could not produce this episode at all without you. Around the world, viewers of the channel were preparing for the meteor shower. Brad set up an all-sky camera to capture the meteor shower. Digital cameras were set up and ready to go, such as Gerald in New York, as well as a small army of visual observers from British Columbia in Canada, Minnesota, Michigan, Wisconsin, northeastern United States, Arizona, Alabama, California, Texas, and Florida. You all know who you are, and thank you for reporting back. Of course, by this point, the media had turned a potential meteor shower into a meteor storm. In fact, many reports stated that people only saw one or no meteors at the peak of the shower. However, that is not the whole picture. I got one report from a viewer called Elsongs in the Mojave Desert, where he saw 11 meteors in 1 hour. The meteors were small with very short streaks. I captured something similar myself in the previous episode, the night before the peak. There was another interesting report from Mackenzie Jore in Michigan, who went out to a very dark site and managed to see 46 meteors between 1 a.m. to 2 a.m. EST. Some were barely visible, but others shot across the sky and described the whole experience as incredible. From these reports, I believe a mediocre meteor shower occurred, but certainly not a meteor storm. But what to make of some people seeing nothing and others seeing something? Well, the reports I've had seem to have a common denominator, and that seems to be light pollution. Those with no or light or little light pollution have had much more success, and this fits in with a lot of reports saying that the meteors were small and therefore not so bright. And here is some footage recorded from around the world. I hope people are not too disappointed, especially with all the media hype about being a meteor storm. With astronomy, a lot of the time predicted events do not come along as expected, but sometimes there are surprises too. It really helps to make it an exciting hobby for us all. Well, that's all for another episode. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'll do my best to answer them. And if you like the video, then please leave a like. It really helps out the channel. And do subscribe for more astronomy episodes. Goodbye and clear skies.